This is not old school bowling. This is the sport you love, played by women who rock. Tonight's matchup, current U.S. amateur champ Diandra Asbaty of Chicago, the USBC spokesperson for youth bowling. She'll take on Shannon O'Keefe of Rochester, New York. This multi-sport star tries to light it up on the lanes tonight. Then, she helped Team USA win a gold medal in 2000. She's one half of tonight's sister act, Kassy Golden. She'll face the 2000 BWBA Rookie of the Year. She's here direct from Melbourne, Australia, Cara Honeychurch. Welcome to the Fashion Show Ball in Las Vegas. It's the 2006 USBC Women's Challenge presented by Geico. We've got great bowling ahead. Now, let's meet our athletes.
Our first competitor this evening is a member of 2006 Team USA. She is also a two-time member of that team. She hails from Rochester, New York. Please welcome Shannon O'Keefe. Her competitor this evening was the 1999 and the 2006 U.S. Amateur Champion, an eight-time member of Team USA from Chicago, Illinois. Please welcome Diandra Asbaty.
Welcome, bowling fans, to fabulous Las Vegas and the USBC Women's Challenge. So glad you could join us tonight, Dave Ryan, alongside Chris Barnes, PBA superstar, Tom Clark as well, a bowling columnist formerly with the USA Today, and Anne-Marie Anderson, lane level, fourth member of our crew. We'll hear from her in a moment as well. Chris, let's start with you. Shannon O'Keefe, a bowler who was a great high school and collegiate softball player, has made the transformation to bowling superstar level as well, hasn't she?
She has a fantastic game, Dave. She does have a lot of international experience. She has some pro experience, and she probably has the most athletic game in this competition. She is a tremendous athlete. She has lots of fire, lots of spunk, and I think you'll see a lot out of her today.
Tom, we talk about Diandra Asbaty, who really has been the face of U.S. junior bowling and now into the U.S. team member play as well. Her potential, probably limitless.
You're right, David. What can you say about Diandra? She's become one of the greatest ambassadors for bowling in the game today, even without a regular platform of TV appearances. Now she's got a chance to appear on television and show everybody what she can do. She's dominated amateur bowling for the last 5 or 6 years. She's won everything.
As promised, let's head down to the fourth member of our crew, Anne-Marie Anderson, standing by with Shannon O'Keefe.
Shannon, this is your first ever match on television. How do you think you're going to react playing not only on television for the first time, but in this environment?
It's pretty nerve-wracking at this moment, getting ready to get on. There's the anticipation of getting ready. Nervous, and for me, nerves creates pressure, and pressure for myself.
There's some hook out there, but that's a plastic ball, and that plastic ball doesn't have very much friction.
Surprising to see Diandra Asbaty miss that 10 pin for an open frame. Shannon, as heard from Anne Marie, has never been on TV. First appearance. It's pretty focused there. Good start for her.
Pouncing on Diandra's miss. This in a one-game match, every single shot is so important, especially early in a match.
This shot gets much further to the right than last shot, but you can see the tremendous athleticism and rotation in her game. It gets back, the five goes right over. It does get blocked off by the four pin coming out of the gutter, but the tremendous pin action got her the double.
Athleticism is something we'll talk about with Shannon Story. Pretty amazing. Back to Diandra Asbaty, crossing over on a high shot. The three pin stands for Diandra.
Well, you heard her say after her first shot, good shot halfway down the lane, and it was much further right. And came up a little light, and she might have tried to help that one just a little bit. That's the tendency in that situation, to try and help it, make it get through the pins, and get that 10 pin out.
Does take care of her mark. She's won 50 international medals. At 27 years old, Shannon O'Keefe has already excelled at two sports. As it turns out, bowling wasn't even on her radar until she was a teenager.
Didn't start bowling until I was 16. My little brother started bowling, so I went to go see him bowl, and there was really cute boys, so I started bowling because of the cute boys.
The center fielder was recruited out of Oregon City High School in 1997.
They offered me a full ride to play softball at Portland State University. Softball is hard on the body. 13 years I played year-round, and it beats you up.
Once a hobby, now a passion. Shannon joined the Pro Bowling Tour and was runner-up to Rookie of the Year at age 19.
Being out on tour and talking to Linda Barnes about her experience on tour, I was like, oh, I could really do that. You know, I watched these women bowl for 4 years on TV, and then to be out there with them was very intimidating, but it was really exciting. USA! I tried out for the U.S. softball team when I was 15. There's not a lot of athletes that get the opportunity to try out for the United States team in two sports. There's no better feeling in my world than to represent your country in another country and hear your national anthem. It's awesome.
Gold medal, the 10-pin team cup 2000 in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Incredible experience for her.
We mentioned that Shannon O'Keefe was a great softball player. You might think that she was a pitcher because of this similar motion between bowling and softball pitching, but actually she was a center fielder.
A slap hitter from the left side was Shannon. And made a pretty good run at the U.S. Olympic team in tryouts for softball.
Ooh.
Wow.
That's Diandra's husband, John. He's a chef in the Chicago area.
Watch this one. It didn't get as quite as far out. She was yelling for it to sit right away. Watch the four pin. Third pin on the left. Wiggles. 8 degrees is enough to topple it, but that wasn't that time.
Nine pin stands for Shannon. Her amazing story. After 1 year of scholarship play, Portland State in softball, had a letter of intent signed to transfer to Nebraska to bowl there, and then decided instead to bowl professionally on the PWBA tour. So never graduated from college. Now she works in a bank in Rochester, New York. One of the hotbeds of bowling in Upper New York State. Very competitive and very athletic. Back to Diandra.
Push.
8-pin count for her. Grew up in Indiana. Now lives in Chicago with her husband John. We saw the chef a moment ago.
It doesn't really look like too bad a shot here, but it does pick up much sooner than she was anticipating. The lanes may already be changing. They practiced on them. As each ball goes down the lane, it picks up oil, makes the front part of the lane hook sooner. And it looks like that's what Deandra's dealing with right now.
Takes care of the mark. Early on, Shannon O'Keefe, Diandra Asbaty. Great match from Las Vegas. And O'Keefe, an early lead on Diandra Asbaty. Shannon works full-time at a bank in Rochester, New York, as it turns out, has other talents as well.
One of the girls I played volleyball with in ninth grade moved up from California, and she knew how to do this. So I just practiced and practiced, practiced until I was able to do it. So here it is. This is my impersonation of a boy in a dishwasher.
Daddy, Daddy, I stepped in a dishwasher and I'm tapping it!
There you go. That's my hidden talent.
Wow, Shannon, that was interesting to say the least. Shannon O'Keefe, the open frame in the third, now to the fourth frame here against Diandra Asbaty.
Sit.
High shot there from Shannon.
Shannon and Diandra, we mentioned they were on Team USA. They went to Denmark last year to go for the World Championship, and they came up 12 pins short, and that was really heartbreaking for both of them.
In Aalborg, Denmark, to Chinese Taipei, Diandra and Shannon, teammates there, told us both in meetings with them, Tom, what heartbreak that was to not win the gold medal. They're used to being right on top in the world when those World Team Championships are complete. Here's Shannon. Covers nicely.
Hate that spare.
Yeah, you should hate that spare. That's one of the toughest spares in bowling right there. You have to hook at it. You have to get it very close to the gutter to have any chance of making it, because you have to create some angle to get that sleeper pin. Tough part. She gets it going to the right very well. Gets it out to about the sixth, seventh board. The tough pin is the back pin, the nine pin sitting behind the three. She covers all of them easily. That's textbook right there.
Back to Diandra, started bowling at age five. Her father very heavily involved. Almost leaves the bucket, seven pin count for her, along with her sister, Kassy Golden. We'll see later on the broadcast here on ESPN2 from Las Vegas against Cara Honeychurch, great left-hander from Australia.
Really unique how Kassy and Diandra grew up in bowling centers, coming home from school, and then they'd take a nap, and then they'd do their homework, and then they'd go out to a bowling center from 9 until midnight every single night.
Diandra covers her spare there. There's a chance if Diandra wins this match, she could take on her sister, Kassy Golden, in the next round if Kassy can win. As it turns out, the two sisters were inspired by their grandmother growing up in Indiana.
Grandma Betty is the most amazing person in my life.
I got my start when I was 5 years old from my grandma Betty. She says, I'm gonna take you bowling. I'm gonna get you started in the league. And she bought me my first purple bowling ball.
She's so proud of Kassy and I. We could have never succeeded in the game like we did. When I was a kid, I thought my schedule was normal. I'd come home from school, my mom would make Kassy and I take a nap, do our homework. My dad would come home at 7 and take us to practice every night from 9:30 till midnight. And that was normal to me. My dad taped us bowling every time. He would be made fun of for it. Everybody said, oh, Mr. Hyman's always got his camera out. She put her bowling on hold to have a beautiful baby.
I took a step back, and I took a different direction for a little while. You know, that's all it took for her to just, man, went right to the top.
You know, she did the right thing. I missed her in that time. I wanted her to be out there with me and taking on the world with me, but she wanted to have a family, and I'm gonna want to have a family one day, so I understand it. I want her to come back, but real bad.
Very competitive people, not toward each other, but we're competitive in general. We know what it takes.
There was a time when Kassy was much better than me, a lot, 10 times better than me, and I didn't bowl as much as she did at practice. You know, I'd put in my couple games and be done. But you know what? When I saw her start winning, I thought, I want to win. And I saw how much time she put in, and I knew what it took.